stories to start your morning. NBA Battle Royale last night. Blazers and Rockets, and the Rockets won this one, snapping Portland's 13-game win streak. Nick, what was your biggest takeaway from the Blazers' run?
Man, that this team needs to be taken seriously. I did not think that this team could be taken seriously in the Western Conference this year. I thought they had a star player in Damian Lillard, a nice player in C.J. McCollum, and a slightly underrated center in Yusuf Nurkic. But when you see what Al-Farouq Aminu is able to do for them, when you see some of the other pieces that they are getting, Terry Stotts is the coach, one of the underrated coaches, this is a team that is a pretty dangerous first-round matchup, a potential, right bounces, dangerous second-round matchup for Golden State. That's what I took from the winning streak.
From the winning streak, you can take a lot of things. Number one thing is I do not want to play them in the postseason. I wouldn't want to get in a seven-game series with them. Portland has always been a tough place to play. Damian Lillard, his herky-jerky style at point guard. Man, there is no point guard that just wants to see that matchup right there. So the other thing that I saw, the only thing that ended this streak was the best team in the NBA and the fact that C.J. McCollum and Damian Lillard didn't hit one three-pointer in the game. Like, so they still were very competitive in this game, almost had a chance to pull it out, weren't able to do it, and these guys didn't play well. So that's a credit to the surrounding cast around them.
All right, to the NFL now. Ndamukong Suh is set to continue his free agent tour. He visited with the Rams yesterday. He'll visit with the Raiders today. Raiders is an interesting choice for him. CC, would Suh be a good fit in Oakland?
Ooh, man. I think that if you look at veteran players, for me, veteran players have always gone to the Raiders and kind of been able to live up to that skull and crossbones type of image. I think with John Gruden, you need a couple dirty guys. You need some guys going to cause a little chaos. And I believe John Gruden and Ndamukong Suh can be one of those guys. Now you got to put him on a tight leash because he will stomp a dude's face. He will stomp you on Thanksgiving. So, yes, when you are the Raiders, you do need some edge players. Edge meaning on the fringe of the rules. And Ndamukong Suh is definitely one of those players.
Man, when we heard he was getting cut by the Dolphins, I said I thought the Rams would be the best fit for him. We visited one yesterday. We'll see what he does. But I said that before the Rams traded for Marcus Peters, signed Aqib Talib. You got Marcus Peters, Aqib Talib, and Ndamukong Suh in a locker room. That might be a little too much for my man Wade Phillips to handle.
Yeah, so maybe I don't know who the team chaplain is there, but they're going to be busy.
And they're going to need someone to pray for them.
Chaplain. Yes.
So the Raiders, listen, you guys know I'm not bullish on some of the moves John Gruden has made. I happen to think Suh has a little more left than a lot of people do. I think Suh, if it's less than $8 million a year, that's about the threshold I would put it at, could be a good value for the right team. So we'll see where he ends up.
All right, to the draft now. Former UCLA quarterback.
He made it in Nebraska.
Josh Rosen worked out for the Browns and the Giants on Tuesday. Browns have the top pick. Giants, second pick in the draft. Total coincidence that he worked out for him. Nick, any chance Rosen has taken top two in the draft?
Absolutely. I don't think Cleveland's going to take him. At this point, I would say Sam Darnold is a favorite versus the rest of the field to go number one. The question is, would the Giants take him, or would a team give the Giants an enormous package of picks to get up to number two so they can take him? I think that is absolutely in play, that Josh Rosen is the second pick of the draft. You know that if I were running the Giants, I would take him number two. I unfortunately am not running the Giants, though, so I cannot guarantee
that. Right, and not because I don't like him, but I follow the guys that follow the draft, and this is the quarterback that we've least talked about going to Cleveland. We talked about Josh Allen. Mm-hmm. We talked about Sam Darnold. And I don't think it helped him, his comments during the season, as far as playing in Cleveland. Now, it's disputed. Did he say it? And did he come back and correct it? But I believe that they're going to take the safest quarterback, and I believe that's Sam Darnold at the number one.
And finally, the NFL says they're considering changing pass interference from a spot-on foul penalty to a 15-yard penalty. CC, does the pass interference rule need adjusting?
The pass interference penalty right now, in the way the league has governed, the way the rules have changed, if you look at all the rule changes in the last 15 to 20 years, it's been to the benefit of the offense. Very seldom have they adjusted the defensive rules to be able to help. But, man, you're talking about something that drives fans crazy, pull their hair out, is just a little ticky-tack, a judgment pass interference call where, man, the team goes from been backed up to now they're at midfield, or they're at midfield and now they're in scoring territory. To also, when you get penalized inside the end zone, it goes right to the 1-yard line. There's nothing more penal in the game then the pass interference. I believe that it should be adjusted a lot like college football because we throw the ball more. The chances of pass have it happening are a lot more prevalent, and it changes the course of games. I don't think teams will just start having 15-yard penalties if they do change the rule. So it's one of them kind of things that will we much rather have the big hit down the field, or do we think guys will start grabbing more because it's less penal? I don't think guys will do that because 15 yards, that's a personal foul. When you see 15-yard penalties, typically the offensive team is going to score some points. So I would like to see an adjustment to be able to help out the defense.
I would like to see an adjustment, but not the exact adjustment they're talking about. Because what you know, I love the spectacular play. And I am afraid that if you make it to where it's just a 15-yard penalty, that what you're going to have is guys, when they get beat for potentially a touchdown, just tackle the guy and take the penalty. Do you of course remember when the face mask, there used to be two versions of it.
Yep.
A 5-yard minor face mask and a 15-yard personal foul face mask. I would like to see the NFL do that with pass interference. 15 and spot. Have it be a spot foul for truly egregious pass interference penalties. Ones where
that's
it's clearly intentional. You've been beaten. You're trying to prevent the touchdown that the guy should have. And a 15-yarder for more of the judgment call ones. And there is a bit of a fringe benefit to that. I'd like to take everyone back to the final play of this NFL season, the Hail Mary. Remember what Malcolm Jenkins did on that Hail Mary? He knew they were not going to call pass interference. So he just wiped out, I think it was Gronk on the play,
he wiped out one of the other receivers. Gronk was able to get back into the
correct
play and almost make the play.
Right, but
he blindsided,
whomever it was.
Hogan, yes.
Knowing it was not going to be a call.
Knowing they're not going to call a spot foul, final play of the Super Bowl, pass interference. But, and we see that on Hail Marys a lot, that guys are like, they're not going to call spot foul in the end zone. If there was the ability to have it be a 15-yard foul, then maybe you wouldn't be able to do that. And maybe the guys would be a little more cautious in those in those individual situations. I know people don't love the referees having more judgment calls, but I think this might be a happy medium. Have the 15-yard variety and the spot foul variety. That's something I would like to see if the NFL would potentially consider. So that would be my solution.
Why don't you just call Roger? You have so many great ideas.
Man.
I mean, we have to hear them all. Why doesn't he?
I got other tweaks.
We know.
By the way, illegal contact shouldn't be an automatic first down. Just 5 yards, do it again. No third and 13.
Once in a while, I take some of the one or two of his little concepts and take them to the media.
Yeah. He called them little concepts.
Yeah,
Nick has spent years developing these.
Years!